What if I say OnePlus is bringing iOS 14's backtap feature with OxygenOS 11.5 on OnePlus devices? That's definitely not gonna happen. But I'm here to show you guys how you can get this feature on all OnePlus devices. I mean, on almost all the smartphones. Hi guys, this is Divaka back with another new cool video. And in this cool video, I'm going to show you how to get backtap feature on any Android phone. So without wasting any more for the time, let's get started. Firstly, download the application from the link in the description box below and install it on your phone. Once done, open the application and hit on get started. Now on your phone, you will see a sensitivity adjustment bar for backtap gesture. Adjust it accordingly to your phone. In case you use a phone cover, then make sure you keep the sensitivity high, if not leave it normal. In my case, I am going to keep it normal and then tap twice behind your phone and check whether your phone recognizes the gesture or not. If yes, then proceed to the next page by tapping on the next button. And all the necessary setting things can be changed later on. Then, you'll go through a notice asking you to download this application from official sources. And if you are a developer, then this application is open source. So you can take advantage as the source code is public. Once you're done with reading the notice, turn on accessibility service for this application from the settings of your phone. And disable battery optimization. Yeah, it will drain your battery quickly. But according to my usage, I have lost around 30 minutes of SOT, as this application uses gyroscope and accelerometer. This consumption will reduce in future as this app is still under development and soon we could see a stable version. Now in gesture section, as I said you earlier, you can change the sensitivity from here. Inside the double tap section, you can assign the action which you want when you double tap at the back of your phone, and this works as if then loop. If you are a CS student, then you will get this point. In simpler words, the actions are performed from top to bottom order. Now add actions which you wish. In case the actions you choose doesn't support this loop, then you will get notified asking you to add requirements or else the actions below this won't be performed. Inside the launch actions, you will get a bunch of actions to launch such as Google Maps, Search, Assistant, Camera and any other apps which you wish to launch by double tapping at the back of your phone. And in actions, you'll get many of other options, and going through every action will make this video longer, so I won't be discussing about all of them here. And same goes with the triple tap, just turn it on. And turning the triple tap on, you'll find some delay in double tap gestures. Do keep that in mind. Lastly, talking about the gates, gates actually mean restrictions in this application. If the particular gate is turned on, then at that time gestures won't work. So for example, display of gate is turned on. Then the gestures won't work when the display is turned off. And I hope you got it what I'm trying to explain. So that's pretty much it for this video guys. Hope you like this video. If yes, don't forget to drop a like and share this video with friends and family. And if you like this content or related to OnePlus devices, especially OnePlus Nord, or if you have one of them, then subscribing to this channel will definitely help you out. And don't forget to press the bell icon so that you'll never miss any cool videos like this. If you still have any doubts or suggestions, don't forget to ask them in the Telegram discussion group from the link in the description box below. If possible, do take an entry level channel membership by just paying 29 rupees from the Google Play credits. That'll give a boost to our channel. So thanks for watching us. I'm Divaka signing off and I will meet you in the next one. Until then, take care of yourself. Bye bye.